move Councillor Phil Davis to move progress. Seconded, Chair. Okay, good evening everybody. Can I just check, can everybody hear me okay?
Yes.
With the microphones. Can I first of all start off by saying, first of all, thank you to members of the public for coming tonight to the first meeting of the Birkenhead Constituency Committee. It's great to see so many people here. Can I also welcome the elected members? I've just had one apology. Alan Brighouse sent an apology, so we'll put forward and record that. Can I just say, I'm going to ask everybody to introduce themselves in a second.
Chris Mead.
Oh, Chris Mead as well. I'm going to ask everybody to introduce themselves in a second, but just a few sort of opening remarks from me. I'm very, very excited really about the constituency committee model that we are rolling out in Wirral. It's our ambition to over time devolve significant powers, responsibility and budgets to each of the four constituency committees and to get more residents, members of the public taking part in decisions that will affect their quality of life and their neighbourhoods. So it is a really important sort of stream of work for the local authority, and I think it's quite exciting to be involved at the very start of this journey. We're basing this model on good practice elsewhere. We've been seeing a number of other local authorities who are much further down the track on neighbourhood working than we are. But in those authorities that we've been to see, and I mentioned Sunderland Council, one of my personal been to see, it's proven to be a really effective model for getting residents and the public involved in taking some important decisions about priorities for their area. And an important kind of starting point, which we'll talk about in due course, is to develop a neighbourhood plan, a constituency plan for Birkenhead that kind of sets out the key priorities that we need to address. So it's with those comments that I really welcome everybody here. I obviously hope you enjoy the meeting, and later on in the agenda there's a public question and answer session, so look forward to questions that people may have. But I'd just like to make those comments. The other thing I'd like to say is that Birkenhead constituency, I believe, is going to be unusual in terms of the four constituency committees, because it is my intention a little later in the proceedings to nominate our local member of parliament, Frank Field, to take over as chair of this constituency committee on a permanent basis. Unfortunately, Frank's train from London has broken down, so he's running a bit late, but he will be here, and at the appropriate time, I will move him as chair of this committee, and I hope I'll get support from members. So I just wanted to kind of up front give that apology from Frank, but he is on his way. Right, okay, before we go to members' code of conduct, declaration of interest, I think it would be helpful to members of the audience if they knew who we all were. So, for those who don't know me, I'm Councillor Phil Davis, I'm Councillor for Birkenhead and Tranmere Ward, and I'm also leader of the council. So, can we go this way?
Good evening, everybody. My name is Joe Potts. I'm one of the strategic directors at the council, and one of my responsibilities is to support the Birkenhead constituency.
Good evening, I'm Brian Kenny, one of the councillors for Birkenhead and
Tranmere. Good evening, I'm Laura McLaughlin, I'm one of the councillors for Rockbury.
My name is Bill Davis, I'm a
councillor. Tony Norby, I've been a councillor for Trenton for just over 1.5 years.
Steve Parks, I'm one of the Claude three.
Denise Roberts, another of the Claude three.
George Davis.
Jim,
can I just make the point that my responsibility in terms of the cabinet is for neighbourhoods, housing and engagement, which is this.
Great. I'm Jim Crabtree, Pitson and Cloughton, councillor.
Denise Reeve, front of councillor.
I'm not Cloughton, she changes.
I'm Councillor Anne McLachlan, Councillor for Bidston St James Ward. I'm Deputy Leader of the Council and I'm Cabinet Member for Improvement and Governance.
Councillor Harry Smith, Bidston St James Ward, and I'm also a Cabinet Member for Highways and Streets.
Councillor Paul Doughty, Friends of the Ward.
Okay, so that's who we four are. thank you for everybody introducing themselves. I just have to now, very briefly, double the apologies for item two, which is a legal requirement. I have to ask if any members of the constituency committee wish to declare any interest. So I just need to formally ask that question.
Chair, through you, I think there'll be a block declaration of interest for example, I sit on the board of Magenta Homes. Likewise, there's organisations where people are responsible by the council, but I don't think that's really a genuine interest. But I'd like to be ready to mention it. We all have different jobs outside of here that might affect some issues.
Yes.
Move that regularly as a vital sort of declaration.
I mean, take your advice, Freddie. I mean, for example, I think all of us, or most of us, will be on school government bodies. So, when there's an issue to do with schools, we would have to sort of register that. But I think, in terms of surging, in terms of this agenda, do we need to register any of those specific interests now, or could we do that if an item comes up later on where we need to declare that interest?
There's the thing in the agenda that I've considered, which point any interest at this point.
Okay, great. Okay, thanks for that. Right. Right. Okay. I'm going on now to. I've done shares opening remarks, which is item three. Sorry, I kind of said that those comments right at the outset. So I'll go on to item four, which is appointment of co-optees. Now, clearly, we have the ability as a constituency committee to co-opt, you know, whosoever we wish, but in line with my comments at the outset about my intention to move our local member of parliament, Frank Field, as chair, in order to do that, I need to move him as a co-opted member of this committee. So can I formally propose that at this stage, so that when he, with non-voting rights, I have to make that clear. So that when he gets here, we can then do what we need to do to formally, I'll formally propose him as chair. But I need to move now that we co-opt Frank Field onto this committee. Is that seconded?
Second.
Is that agreed?
Agreed.
Okay, thank you very much. Right, so I'm going to leave item 5 and 6 until Frank gets here, and then move swiftly on to item 7, which is the terms of reference for the constituency committee, which is in the agenda pack. Now, can I ask Paul?
Can I just make a point that it just lists Bidston as the board, it's Bidston St James.
Right.
Okay.
Okay, well spotted, Harry. Yeah, Bidston St James. Okay, we'll amend that. Okay, can I ask Paul just to introduce this paper, please?
Well, what we propose in the recommendations is the overall
Stuart.
Congratulations.
Chair, have you got a mic? It's very difficult, you know, because now you've got the air conditioning going, and now we've got...
It's a coffee machine.
Or whatever it is.
The air conditioning might have to say the record.
We have got a mic pull, that's why I'm trying to project.
You're okay, but some people aren't.
Is I also okay?
No, you're a mumble in the background, I'm afraid of.
So did you like to explain, if I can, the terms of reference for this committee are already contained within the constitution, but they are a broad framework of terms that sets out what the current arrangements are for this committee. What you have in front of you is in paragraph 1.2 of the extracts from the cabinet report, which sought at the time.
this is starting to feel to me lost in the process. I'm like, I'm sitting there all the time. I feel like I'm already so.
Here, here.
I think we need to explain to people that this is the first meeting sort of thing. I know we're going through a lot of process and some of the language really is not, you know, it's all.
But there are certain preliminary things that we've got to do tonight that we won't need to do in each of these hours. This is one of them.
So
bear
with us.
Sorry. Yeah. Okay, so the recommendation on page 5 of this report, you note Article 10 to be updated to ensure committees have the scope and flexibility to provide for constituency working model.
Agreement to put this on their action.